Einstein once said, a person who has not made his great contribution to science before the age of 30 will never do so. Einstein published four groundbreaking papers in 1905 when he was 26, and we describe him as a genius, someone with exceptional intellectual ability. So is there a point where we hit our intellectual peak? Where we'll be the smartest we'll ever be in our lives? Defining human intelligence is complex. I've mentioned previously that it includes your capacity for reasoning, planning, problem-solving, abstract thought, self-awareness, communication, creativity, and learning, to name a few. One theory is that intelligence can be broken down into two types, crystallized and fluid intelligence. Fluid intelligence is the capacity to think logically and solve problems, independent of acquired knowledge, like how quickly you can solve this puzzle. Crystallized intelligence is the ability to use the knowledge you've built up from what you've learned, like knowing the elements of the periodic table or the names of the spells in Harry Potter. Placing a peak age on our cognitive skills is tricky and depends on how we measure intelligence, if we can measure it accurately at all. Tests of fluid intelligence shows it peaks in young adulthood and slowly, gradually declines. Crystallized intelligence remains much more stable and has been shown to decline as late as our 70s. Is there a magical point where they meet? In a 35-year-old long study, tests of general mental ability showed that, on average, your abilities increase until your late 30s or early 40s. Mental abilities are stable until your mid-50s or early 60s. From your late 60s, things start to decline. The proportion of physicists who did their prize-winning work by age 30 peaked in 1923 at 31%. By the year 2000, this dropped to 0%. And prize-winning work by age 40 occurred in only 19% of cases by the year 2000. There's no clear or easy way to tell when we're at our brightest, and there are lots of different opinions. So I asked you to see if we could all piece together our thoughts.
In fields like math and physics, people are tend to be the most creative and make the largest impacts when they're very young, like early 20s. But I'm not sure that having revolutionary creative ideas is necessarily the same thing as being smartest.
Like, at your, like, physical peak, it's also when your brain kind of hits its peak.
I feel like you're the smartest you will ever be, as judged by IQ tests around the age of 25.
Let's throw a number out there. I'll say 65. There you go. It's like old enough that I remember all the things that I've learned over the course of my life, but just on the edge of when I'll probably start forgetting them, so, yeah.
Well, I mean, smartness is a complicated thing, but a lot of it has to do with experience, right? And if you're living a life where you're constantly having new experiences, which I think by definition you will always have to be, then you are always smarter in the current moment than you previously were.
I think I know a lot more now. And not just like facts, but sort of how things work, how the world works.
Because you can be very, very smart at any age.
And MindSponge wrote that maybe peak intelligence is dependent on the person. William Vanderbeek wrote that while famous scientists published their biggest discoveries in their 20s, he feels smarter now in his 30s. Jack Freeman and Eric wrote that our peak would be around 30. Just Having Fun wrote that the peak is in the late 40s, where people have a wealth of experience and are still in good health. And yada yada yada. If you haven't already, let me know your thoughts in the comments and subscribe to BrainCraft for a new brainy video every week.